Here is AEROFILMS' first ever guide, the football grounds, all 92 grounds in the Premier League and the Football League. Beautiful images of some of the old stadia. There's Millwall before it was done. A lovely picture there of Stanley Park. You've got Liverpool on one side and Everton on the other side. The Twin Towers. Wembley Stadium, Highbury before the North Bank was put up. Aston Villa as it used to look before three quarters of the ground were totally refurbished. First one to go was that, then it was the whole tent, and that was more recent in 2000. Former home of Barnet Football Club, Underhill. Barnsley Football Club, how the ground also used to look back in the day. That was the new stand just being put up. Both ends now, old seater, and this will be the next one to go. Just seats put in the bottom terrace. Birmingham City. Yep, that's how it used to be. You know the story, the David Gold and the other guy came in. Cameron Brady, the ground was redeveloped three quarters. Are they going to move to a new stadium, or is that main stand going to be redeveloped? Look at Blackburn Rovers before they won the FA Premier League in 95. Yeah, Jack Walters Minions certainly improved that stadium. Some old mills. There's Nuttall Street. I think that's the Blackburn end, and that's Darwin end, and of course the Walkers Steel. That was built, I think, in 1986 or 87. Blackpool, the former home of Bolton Wanderers, Burnden Park, AFC Bournemouth's old ground, Dean Court, rotated 90 degrees and totally redeveloped. Valley Parade, of course, these have just had extra tiers put on top. Brentford, famous ground, of course, four pubs in each corner, absolutely wonderful stadium to visit. The old home of Brighton and Hove Albany, the Goldstone ground they left in 97. It was a major saga until they moved into the Emic Stadium, and they could make a movie about it. Bristol City, not a bad ground back then. Both ends have been refurbished. Bristol Rovers at Bath City's ground. Bury, Gig Lane, Abbey Road, Cambridge United, the old home of Cardiff City, Ninia Park, Carlisle United. Of course, 95, that stand was demolished and the new two-tier stand, well, one-tier stand was put up. The ground was supposed to be redeveloped all the way, but they fell into financial trouble under Michael Knight. The Valley going under redevelopment back at their new home in 93. Looks a lot different. Chelsea, that's how Stamford Bridge used to look. Three quarters of the ground have been totally redeveloped. There's hotels and all there now. The Diva Stadium of Chester City. Old ground, Saltergate, Chesterfield. Layer Road, Colchester. Coventry City's old home, Highfield Road. Crewe Alexandra and Gresty Road. Just one new stand being put up and minor adjustments. Crystal Palace with the old Holmesdale end. That's that one there. The old ground, the Featums. Darlington, of course, moved to a bigger ground. The old ground of Derby, that's the baseball ground. Doesn't look that bad. But of course they moved to Pride Park in 97. Bellevue of Doncaster Rovers. Not the best ground in the league, but of course they moved to the Keep Moat Stadium. And one of the best grounds in the Premier League. Proper old style ground. Goodison Park. The old park end, of course, came down in 94 and replaced by the stand that is there now. Exeter City St James's Park. That's been totally redeveloped. And there is talk of trying to redevelop the other two ends, but as you can see, very tricky. Fulham's famous Craven Cottage, beautiful ground. The old Lynch stand, the old cottage, beautiful ground. Both ends being redeveloped, all seater stands. Yep, that's how Priestfield Stadium used to look. All the way up till about 97, and of course the Gordon Road stand was demolished, then the Rainham End, then the Medway stand was put up, and that of course is the famous Golf End. Yeah, it's been a temporary stand since 2004. Grimsby Town in Cleethorpes, Hartlepool United, before it was refurbished and redeveloped into a very, very nice, tidy ground. Hereford United. Huddersfield Town used to play at Leeds Road. Hull City's old ground there. Boothery Park. Ipswich Town. First all-seater stadium in England. Both these ends have had extra tiers put on top. Leeds United. The East Stand is being put up in this picture. I've got to admit, that is a lovely ground to see. It's a beautiful way the old blends in with the new. Leicester City at Filbert Street. One main stand put up. Couldn't redevelop the ground, hence they moved a couple of metres to a new ground. Too much housing. Leighton Orient, proper old-fashioned ground. Lincoln City. Liverpool's famous Anfield. The famous Kop, knocked down in 95. Luton Town's cramped Kenilworth Road. The beautiful Main Road, which they left in 2003. The famous old Kippix End. Old Trafford before more redevelopment was done. An old look at Field Mill, now totally transformed. Middlesbrough's old ground, Ayresome Park, before they moved to the Riverside Stadium. Another look at Millwall's new ground. That's how St James's Park, Newcastle used to look. The county ground of Northampton Town. Only three sides. There was a cricket pitch which is still there, but they had to move to six fields as this ground was virtually condemned. Norwich City at Carrow Road, the second all-seater stadium in England. Of course, the new south stand looks a lot better than that. Nottingham Forest with the old Trent End Terrace. Notts County very famously built all three sides for £3.5 million. That was absolute peanuts back in 93. Oldham Athletic, one of the coldest grounds in the Football League. Oxford's old ground, Manor Road, now a hospital. Peterborough United before the redevelopment. Another ground that's gone under a total transformation, home park of Plymouth Argyle. Portsmouth. There's Port Vale before their transformation. I mean, these pictures look amazing. Look at detail. There's so much character in that ground before it was all pulled down. QPR looks exactly the same. They'll be moving to a new stadium because there's housing there. That's the school end. And this is a very prime location, so it's worth a lot of money, this land. Reading's old ground, Elm Park. Rochdale, I mean, again, another amazing transformation. Millmore, home of Rotherham United, now demolished. Scarborough, no longer in existence. Scunthorpe United, Gladford Park, one of the first new grounds in 1989, moving from the old showground, still looks exactly the same. Sheffield United's Bramall Lane, of course, that stand's been pulled down. Can't remember, I think it's the John Street stand. Hillsborough, there's Shrewsbury's grounds. Old Stadium Gay Meadow. A man in a boat would have to retrieve all the balls out of the River Severn. Southampton's old ground, the Dell. Very cramped indeed. Rootsholes virtually looks the same, just one new stand and seating bolted on the terracing. Stockport County, no longer in the Football League. That stand was redeveloped in 97. The Victoria Ground of Stoke. Very old ground, of course, now playing at the lovely Britannia Stadium. The Roker Park, classic football ground. But of course, that went in 97. Swindon Town, first season in the Premier League. That's been demolished, and that's now got seating in it. Torquay United, nice little ground. Tottenham Hotspur, White Hart Lane. Of course, they'll be moving, I think, to a new ground or redeveloping this one. I'm not sure on that. I don't think neither are Tottenham. Tranmere Rovers, again, very cheaply built. I think theirs was just over £3 million. Sadly, they dropped into the non-league, but I'm sure they'll be back in no time. There's Walsall at the Bescot Stadium. Now with the new William Sharp stand, that's how it used to look. The same as Scunthorpe's. Watford, another ground that's totally been changed three quarters. That's now the Elton John stand, but that's how Vicarage Road used to look. There's West Bromwich Albany, the famous Hawthorns. Upton Park, of course, last season ever as a Premier League ground. An amazing area to visit, watch football. Beautiful ground, amazing atmosphere. That is one ground that's going to be very, very sorely missed. Wigan Athletic. It's sort of a football ground, but now playing at the JJBs. Wimbledon, when they used to play at Selhurst Park. Wolverhampton Wanderers, before it was fully redeveloped. I think that's the old Waterloo end. I might be corrected on that in the comments. The racecourse ground of Wrexham, a new stand has been put there. And Wickham Wanderers, first season in the Football League. That's a nice two-tier stand, and there's another lovely stand being put there, but that's how the ground used to look. Of course, moving there in 1990, and we finish off at York City. Tidy little ground, Boothley Crescent, also known as the Kit Kat Crescent. And there you go, the end of the book. Absolutely incredible. Look at some old football grounds, how football grounds used to look. This was, of course, the first edition of a big series from AEROFILMS. I've got plenty of these books. An amazing guide to football grounds. I love them. Anyway, I'm going to leave the video there because we are running a bit too long. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll say goodbye.